Let's move right on. Milan, allow me to come in there. Raymond has put out its earnings. It's been a weak Q4. Sanjay Bahl is a group CFO, Raymond, who now joins in on the phone line. Mr. Bahl, thank you for being with us on ET Now. Can you just walk us through the highlights of Q4 and tell us how the various categories have performed? Which were the segments that were the worst hit?
So let me give you a perspective. Our benchmark for comparison in this quarter ideally is the last quarter three, where our performance was really impacted by the demonetization impact and the liquidity squeeze which resulted. In this quarter, quarter four, what is heartening to note is that our core business has bounced back from the demonetization impact. And we have now a growth in branded textile, which is 9%, and an apparel, which is now in high double digits at 16% growth over the quarter three. Our EBITDA margins, which were impacted in quarter three and came down to 6.1%, have now bounced back to 9.6% in quarter four. So overall, we achieved a revenue growth of 13% and came back to profitability at a net level, where we registered a PAT of 33 crores. As against a loss of 16 crores in quarter three.
Okay, Mr. Bahl, let's talk about the apparel sector, because despite some positive signs seen in that segment, the margins continue to be under pressure. What's the reason for that, and any plans to boost this vertical going forward?
The business really got impacted at the gross margin level because of a couple of reasons. One, clearly, the end-of-season sales just got extended, and the number of end-of-season sales for the entire industry was very high in this quarter and, in a way, an abnormal quarter. The number of days of discount sales to normal sales was much higher in this quarter. So this had an impact. As all players were trying to liquidate the inventory that got built up with the drop in consumer demand in quarter three. So there was really a clear focus and initiative to get the consumers back to stores by deep discounting.
Okay, what's the growth that you see in the retail business and even the expansion strategy in that sector going forward? Any capex that you have planned?
In future, the strategy is to go asset light. So, as I mentioned earlier, is to go the franchisee route, and we are opening up now mini Raymond stores across tier 3 to tier 5 towns. So that will be clearly helping us in our growth strategy forward. On the branded apparel side also, we are looking at smaller apparel stores in the to increase our footprint in the interiors from tier 3 to tier 5, we see a larger proportion of our investments going there, which will also be franchise-led. So overall, we do not see a large capex happening next year. Would be in the order of about 25 to 30 crores, really, to fund our expansions.
Now, we also saw a significant uptick in the garmenting business on a Q-on-Q basis. Can you tell us a little bit about the growth over there and what have been the key growth drivers that really aided this?
Yeah, so garmenting business is clearly on track. We have good relationships with our U.S. and Europe customers, and the whole focus is to keep building on this and expanding the strength that we have in integrating a fabric along with our garmenting capabilities. So in this quarter four, there was a carryover of some orders as well from quarter three to quarter four, which you see in the quarter four results. But fundamentally, our relationships with our customers is very strong, and that is now going to be further bolstered through our facility which we are going to commission this year in Ethiopia, and this will strengthen the relationship and the solution offerings that we can provide to our customers.
Can you also tell us what is the outlook for the tools and the hardware business, because auto components continues to remain fairly profitable? Are there any plans to scale up this business?
Yeah, so the auto component has performed admirably well last year and has turned around, has delivered a high return on capital. EBITDA margins have been around 15%. So a business which has got marquee customers as well. So we will certainly look at low capex expansions in this business. We have investments which have already been made, and certain product categories may see some expansion plans in this business. In the tools and hardware business is where a strategic turnaround is currently in place, and we see over the next 12 to 18 months this whole strategy of turning this business around getting executed. And this really is about reviving our consumer demand in some of the export markets, rationalizing a product portfolio, and also a lot of cost rationalization to bring the profitability back. So tools and hardware, encouraging signs have been seen in quarter four, and over the next year, we see this business clearly bouncing back to profitability.
All right. Mr. Bahl, just, before we continue this conversation, I just want to address the M&M numbers that have just come out. The April sales figure, as you can see on your screens, has come in at 39,357 units versus an ET Now poll pegging the figure at 42,200 units. And, compared to the corresponding quarter, or rather the corresponding month, April 2016, the number, of course, has seen a bit of a dip from 39,357 to 241,863 units. So there has been a dip, and in fact the number has come in below ET Now expectations. The tractor poll, however, has done pretty well. The tractor sales have come in at 26,000 units versus our own estimates of 23,400 units. So while the overall auto sale numbers may look a bit disappointing, it's the tractor sales that's actually done pretty well. A good 3,000 units margin from the what the market was expecting. You did see the stock actually spike up quite a bit in reaction to that, to these numbers that have come. But yes, of course, we've cooled off a bit from those highs. It's a mixed bag, really. You could not really point to the direction in which these numbers are, because overall sale numbers do look a bit disappointing. We were expecting 42,200. It's come in at 39,357. Not the case with the tractor sales. Tractor sales, however, have done decently well, coming in at 26,000 units. But we have with us the management of Raymond. And Mr. Bahl, you know, we were just talking about your results. But away from that, I just want an update on the Thane land parcel. What do you plan to do there now?
I hope I had some good news to share, in this quarter. But regulatory approvals do take a lot of time. All I can share with you is that the team is working on securing these regulatory approvals. They're working on evaluating all the options that we have for development of land. And hopefully, I think by the time we talk again in July, we should have some news. But I can share that there is a lot of work that is happening.
Okay, and finally, what's the outlook forward? Tell us a little bit more about growth. What kind of level margins can we expect in FY18?
We have an expansion strategy for our branded apparel business, and we will grow aggressively through the franchisee route, which will be cost effective as well as profitable for the business. Our Amravati and Ethiopia plant are going to be commissioned this year, so that will give us the benefits in the years to come. We expect a turnaround in the tools and hardware business to happen this year. So a lot of positives going for us, which will help us to certainly improve our performance and to really get back to the pre-demonetization levels of growth and profitability that we had aspirations for, and which got impacted in the second half of last year.
All right, Mr. Bahl, thanks so much for joining us, giving us a perspective on the quarter four numbers. Well, it's been a weak quarter for Raymond, and the stock is reacting to that, down by about 3%. We'll slip into a short break, but when we come back, we'll be addressing the technicals as well as giving you some commodity strategies.